Watch your screen. The Knights of God in His Anointed Servant.
Come on! In the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, you evil spirit dwelling in this body, I command you now. Come on! Out of her! Out!
Viewers, what you are seeing?
Every chains of Satan in this life, every evil attack, out! I command you, darkness, right now, manifest yourself and come out of this body now. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. You foul spirits dwelling in this body, I command you, come on! Out! Who are you? Come. Who are you dwelling in this body?
We are many.
Eh?
We are much.
You are much. What have you done to her life?
Don't disturb. Don't disturb her. She will see what I will do to her.
Eh?
She will see what I will do to her.
She will see what you will do to her. How did you come into her life?
It's long ago. It's longer.
At the appearance of the light of Jesus, darkness disappears. Now I command you, you spirit of darkness, right now, manifest yourself and come out of this body now. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
No. She will see. She will see. Yeah.
Manifest yourself and come out of her. Come on. In the name of Jesus Christ. Ah! In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Something left me.
Something left you. What is it?
Immediately you shout in the name of Jesus.
As I shout in the name of Jesus, something left you. What is it that left you?
Something jumped out of my heart.
Something jumped out of your heart. That was the cause that made you to be here today.
Thank you, Jesus.
That is the freedom you have been waiting for God for. Today you have received the freedom.
Thank you, Jesus. I'm free. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. Right, let's put our hands together for Jesus Christ.
My name is Ehiwisi Angela. I was here March 10. It all happened years ago when I was in school. I was sleeping in the night, myself and my colleagues. Suddenly, a golden snake ran down my neck, my hand, and my leg. I shout and shout and shout. Nobody could answer me. Even my colleagues that were sleeping close to me, I tried to touch her, but I was unable to. When I woke up, I was querying the two of them, telling them that you guys heard me shouting, so you could not answer me. They told me that they didn't hear me, that I didn't shout. I told them that upon all the shouting that I've been shouting since you mean nobody heard me, they said no. Then I kept quiet. They sat there and asked me what happened. I told them nothing. Some days later, if I'm walking, I'll be perceiving blood all over me, smelling all around me. So the thing was too much. I decided to call my elder brother. After telling him, he told my big brother. My big brother said, yes, he knew it, that I should go for deliverance. Before I even woke up from the dream self, it was as if my heart was bouncing up, as if I want to give up. After then, the deliverance, I didn't go. So I started praying on my own, and my brothers also joined me. And we started praying together. Since then, that time, till last year, challenge everywhere. Even my exam, if I write exam, next year I will see, carry over. Then the people that we wrote the exam together, they will pass. After going back to write the carry over, next year again, I will see, the carry over will still reflect. Even in my final year, the same thing. So at times I'll wake up, I'll see strange fingers on my body. So it came to a time I was asking myself, am I a baby that will finger myself that will not know? Then I, without it, I know that it's not ordinary. Then I complained to my mom. I thank God for my mom and my elder sister that find herself in this great ministry. So my mom told me that if I come, because I was not saying Benin, that if I come back, then it will bring me into this ministry. Then she told me that she will send me the pastor number. She sent me Pastor Israel Obaseki number. I called him. Then he told me if I come back that I should come to the church. I should come and see him. But when I came back, I didn't go to him. Then I went straight to the prayer line. The complaint was too much. To the extent my mom told me a story. When I was a kid, what happened? There's a place she do go to harvest rice, but not knowing that the place there is a seed there, she didn't know. Not until the baby that she carried along was crying. The cry was too much. Then somebody heard the baby voice and told her, who is the owner of that baby? Then she said she's the one. The person told her that you wouldn't have come here with the baby, that they don't used to come to, they don't used to carry a baby to this place. Then she told me the following day, 2 days after, she noticed a change for the in the life of the baby.
And who was the baby?
I was the one.
Okay, go ahead.
So that was all she told me. Then when I came back, she brought me to this great ministry. More grace, everybody.
More grace. You said in school, you were sleeping with your schoolmates in your rooms.
Yes, sir.
And a goody snake.
Yes, sir.
Came in the night.
Yes, sir.
To enter you.
Yes, sir.
Eh?
Yes, sir.
How? How did he enter you?
My neck. He wrapped on my neck, my hands, and my leg. Then I was not stretching. My heart was bouncing up like someone wanted to give up.
And you were shouting. Your bedmates didn't hear you.
No, sir.
And when you woke up, you told them, I have been shouting. They said they never hear you shouting.
Yeah. Yes, sir.
So since then, you grew.
Yes, sir.
Challenges everywhere.
Yes, sir.
You write exam.
Yes, sir.
Frustration.
Yes, sir.
Disappointment everywhere.
Yes, sir.
So you came to the prayer line.
Yes, sir.
So now, after the prayer line, what now happens to you? Mm. Or during the prayer line and after, what happens?
During the prayer line, pastor laid hand on me. I can't even tell where I am at that particular moment. But while pastor was praying, immediately he shouted the name of Jesus. As in something jumped out of my heart suddenly.
You were released.
Yes, sir.
Shall we give a clap of praise to Jesus Christ? At the mention of the name of Jesus Christ, every name must bow. The golden snake that entered her back was the one that flew out of her at the mention of the name of Jesus Christ. Everyone here, whatever that suddenly came into your life, since that thing came into your life has been miserable. I pray by reason of your listening to this testimony today, such will jump out of your life in the name of Jesus. Just at a touch, of the sisters of her head at the prayer line, you saw the way the tongue was moving. Do you watch it just now? Okay. The way the tongue were moving, that was the golden snake that was at work. Alright. And as long as that golden snake remains there, she goes nowhere in life. Life becomes useless and never gets meaningful. That was why Jesus came. For this reason was the Son of Man manifested, that he may destroy the works. Do you see how on the screen? I know that even she see herself now, she is surprised. That was the golden snake that entered her. When light and darkness comes, darkness disappears. We carry light. You are a man of light. You are a woman of light. So when we come in contact with these forces, they go. You see, since this evil spirit, golden snake, has been in her, it will make her to get provoked, anger unnecessarily. Eh?
True, yes, sir.
Unnecessary should be annoyed.
Yes, sir.
So now she'll be annoyed of herself.
Yes, sir.
She can be annoyed of everyone around her.
Yes, sir.
Even without them doing her wrong.
Yes, sir.
She'll just be angry.
Exactly.
She can just wake up early in the morning and just be angry.
Yes, sir.
People begin to, but yesterday there was nothing. What happened now?
Yes, sir, it's true.
She will just want to be on her own.
Yes, sir, it's true.
Don't want to relate with anybody.
No.
That's a golden snake. So, since you came to the prayer line, something flew out of you, you received your deliverance. Now, okay, how has your life been, and what can you tell us now about your experience?
I give glory to God. Since that time to today, those strange dreams I used to have, no longer there. Even before then, when I came back, my friend called me telling me to go to the hospital, that the chest pain I'm always complaining of, I should go and do test. When he was saying it, it was strange in my ear. Then I have to ask, what did you say? When he repeated, I said, no, there is nothing like that. He also measured my temperature. I told him, no, nothing like that. Even when he was talking, I do remember, if it was before, I would be shouting and angry. But that very day, that spirit of anger was unable to come. And since that time till now, my sleeping, the way I slept is very great, cool.
You sleep normal now?
Yes, sir.
You don't easily get annoyed again?
No, sir.
Your health is normal now?
Yes, sir.
You don't hear that voice again?
No, sir.
To God be glory. Shall we give a clap of hands to Jesus Christ? Yes. Is even reflecting on you. Now your real person is coming out and your beauty is coming out. We bless the name of the Lord. Now it is now you can fulfill your destiny now as you remain in God. Now you are having the deliverance and the restoration prayer book in your hand. What is all about that?
The very day that on the 10th, when they gave me this material, immediately I opened it. What I saw inside was, Jehovah God, do that which only you can do in my life. So even before the prayer line, before it starts, I started praying inside my heart, telling God he should do what only he can do in my life, because I know that I cannot do it myself, but he alone.
You were using this prayer book to pray?
Yes, sir.
To God be glory. And that is the purpose of this deliverance and restoration prayer book.
Yes, sir.
When you use it in your prayer, it causes you deliverance.
Yes.
And it opens door for restoration.
Yes, sir.
Of your Lord's glory.
Yes, sir.
We bless the name of the Lord.
Amen.
So what advice have you to give us today who are hearing your wonderful testimony of what God has done for you?
Yeah. My advice is that it's good faith. First of all, it matters a lot. It's good for us to put our trust in God, and we should believe God that with him, everything is possible, because Jehovah God, he answered prayer.
God bless you. Grace be unto you. your deliverance remain permanent in Jesus' name. Amen. Okay.
After the deliverance, there was one day I was passing in the street, and if any time I pass that particular place, the woman there, if any time I greet her, she just answer me as if she didn't see me. But after the deliverance, a few days after I was passing, I greeted the woman. The woman dropped what she was doing and turned at me and said, my daughter, where have you been? I said, I've been around. She said, okay, it's just that I've not been seeing you. And then I left. While I was going, something occurred to me. I said, I bet this is where I used to pass, and this is the woman I used to greet. I was asking myself, so what happened since all those times?
The golden snake was there. It was not you, the woman we are seeing. The woman was seeing someone else. What was reflecting in you then was the golden snake, another image. It is now the golden snake is gone. The real you is manifesting. Do you know that there are many people who are carrying what does not belong to them? The image they are carrying is not their own. The face they carry is not their own. But you that is a normal human being, you see them, their face normal. But when it is really time for God's favor or breakthrough, blessing for their life, those who will help them will not see them. Real identification. And that is why Satan came. To manipulate such person's life. So the deliverance, you were delivered. That's why the woman can see the real you. You say, where have you been? But you pass here every day. You greet her. She will answer you as if she doesn't know you. Thank you. You are welcome. God bless you. Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus. More grace.
More grace. God bless you. Grace be unto you. So remain close to God as God continues in your life in Jesus' name. Amen.